If you run a small business and are looking for a way to strengthen your connection with your current clients and customers, or even potential clients and customers, text marketing, also known as SMS marketing, may be a really good fit. In this video, I'll share with you a few reasons why you'll want to strongly consider incorporating text marketing into your business now or maybe in the near future, and also give you a few examples of how you could go about effectively doing so. Hi y'all, I'm Vivian Walton, the Seasoned Marketer, and I share marketing tips, tools, and tactics with resourceful business owners. If you're new here, every Monday I release a new marketing video. So if that's something that you're into, go ahead and hit that subscribe button right now or follow me on any one of my other social media accounts. So for today's video, I want to start by sharing some really interesting statistics about text marketing, also known as SMS marketing. SMS stands for short message service and basically refers to texting. For the sake of this video, I'm just going to refer to it as text marketing from here on out, but know that they are interchangeable. It probably comes as no surprise to you that text marketing is a truly effective tool that business owners can use to stay in constant communication with their target audience, whether that be current clients and customers or potential clients and customers. But what I find is that a lot of small business owners have a tendency to shy away from even considering text marketing, or at least right now, because they find it to be a bit intrusive maybe. And so the reason I want to share these statistics with you is to give you an opportunity to maybe reframe that mentality so that you can see that it is not only on the rise, but that it is strongly becoming the preferred method of communication with clients and customers. And so let's go ahead and dive right in and start talking about the stats. 74% of cell phone and smartphone users have no unread text messages. So unlike an email, there is a much lower chance that when your business sends a text message, that the text message will sit there unopened for days, if not weeks. What is even more impressive is that 95% of SMS messages are opened and responded to within 3 minutes of being delivered. A real life example of this is digital coupons. Statistics have found that when companies send digital coupons via email and they're opened on a smartphone, at max, 2% of them are redeemed. On the flip side, when they surveyed customers about their texting habits, 85% of them said that they redeem a digital coupon that is sent to them via text within 1 week of receiving it. Additionally, 75% of people stated that they wouldn't mind receiving a text from a company or business. Of course, given that they had opted in for the service, customers actually consider this to be a nice personal touch. Now, with all of that being said, there are a few things that I want to point out here. If you are watching this video and you're thinking, you know, I had never really considered using text marketing for my business, but it sounds intriguing and it's something that I may want to try here in the near future, there are a few things that you're going to have to consider before you can actually launch. So the first consideration, and this is probably the most important one, is that you're going to have to figure out a way for people to opt in to text messages. You can't arbitrarily just go through, take your clients and customers' phone numbers and start texting them. You have to create a way or a mechanism for them to opt in to text messages. And you're also going to want to be very clear about what type of information you're texting them. To springboard off of this, the second consideration you'll want to have is what platform or app you want to use in order to effectively use texting to stay in communication with your clients and customers. So you definitely do not just want to use your own personal cell phone to be sending text messages. That's not appropriate, and trust me, you don't want to do that anyways. You need to really research and look into platforms that will be able to handle all of that for you, because eventually what you're going to want to do is be able to track and have statistics to show you how well your texting campaigns have done, depending on if you're doing certain holiday campaigns or if you're doing launches for certain products and services. You're going to want to keep the data separate so that you could see how effective they were in case you want to try new things. And lastly, the third consideration is to actually give some thought about how you want to use text marketing strategically in your business. Because text marketing gives you such intimate access to your clients and customers, you want to be sure that you are sharing valuable information with them. So you definitely don't want to be a nuisance to them because they'll opt out of the texting. And so what you want to do is go in and take a look at how you can effectively incorporate this text marketing into your business model. So that's the next step here that we're going to talk about. Let's review three ways that you can incorporate text marketing into your business. Conversation. Use text marketing as a form of conversation and communication with your target audience. So allow it to be an extension of what you may do on social media or perhaps through your email marketing. When you use it in this way, it isn't focused on the products and services you sell, but rather in providing valuable information in small, digestible snippets through text. A few months ago, I signed up to receive John A. Cuff's weekly text, and I absolutely love getting these every single week. Now, if you haven't heard of John A. Cuff, he's an author that writes about productivity and mindset, and so he recently launched a book. Now, this texting campaign was actually in relation to this new book that he launched, and what he does is on a weekly basis, he will send you a topic or just an inspirational quote that he pulls from his book. And these weekly gems are not only inspirational, but also encourage you to take action. And I think that is really what provides a lot of value to me personally. And so this is a great way to set up a weekly text that will not only remind people of the product or service that you offer, but can also inspire them to kind of get moving and take action. Information. Using text marketing to disperse really important information to your clients and customers or prospective clients and customers is a great way to not only help keep them informed, but to also help your business as well. So this is a perfect option for people that may be in industries or businesses that have a lot of moving parts and where information changes regularly. For example, if you own a brewery and every Friday you have live music performances from various artists, one of the campaigns you can launch is basically asking patrons that if they want to stay informed and know ahead of time who the live performance is going to be for the week, for that Friday, that they can sign up for this text. And what you could do is every Sunday send a text message out telling them who the live performance will be on Friday and also sharing with them your Friday specials. This would give people enough time and opportunity to be able to plan an outing on a Friday night and could also help you promote your nightly specials. Another way that you could effectively use text marketing for information purposes is if you happen to be in a business where you keep account information. So for example, Geico sends me a monthly text that tells me a week in advance when they're going to be drafting my policy amount out of my checking account. Now, I like knowing that just because I like staying on top of my finances, but they also use that same texting app to provide opportunities to let me know if I'm missing any information that needs to be uploaded or if I've been in an accident or have a windshield claim or something like that. They'll tell me what information is needed and usually they'll send it to me in a link so that all I have to do is click on it and then it will link me to the form that needs to be filled out. This is something that I prefer as opposed to receiving an email that then goes into my inbox with 1,000 other emails that I haven't opened yet. Promotion. Using text marketing as a form of promotion is probably the most popular way that most businesses are using text marketing today. You can send digital coupons via text. You can also let people know about any holiday sales or specials that you're running. Here are two very good examples of how current businesses are using it to promote their sales and services. This is a secondhand consignment store that texts their sales information every weekend to customers. And this one right here is a coffee company that promotes upcoming holiday sales. Moving further into 2021 and beyond, Text marketing is only going to get more prevalent and popular and also become the preferred method for people to receive a lot of important and useful information. And so if your small business isn't considering using text marketing at this point, you may want to start just kind of thinking about how you can incorporate it into your day-to-day business or even into your long-term strategic plan. If you like this video, remember that every Monday I release a new video that could help you save time and money when it comes to marketing your business. Don't forget that I also have a website at www.theseasonmarketer.com where I have all of my videos uploaded and also blog posts and free digital downloads that you can take advantage of here today. So go check that out. Thanks again for tuning in to another Monday Marketing Minute. I'll catch you guys next week, same time and place.